happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? It's Craft Farms here, back with another video. And today we are back on Dad's Farm. I just loaded up the game. So we're going to go around and get our stuff started. The last time I quit, I was fueling up and repairing the combine. And we're done with that, so we'll just pull the truck over here. Out of the way. Go, here's the combine. So we're on field 4, cutting away. We're gonna get this guy running again. There we go. This guy we gotta get running again. We should also repair him before do anything more. And its course is gone. Okay. We will record a new course, I guess. And then we'll repair the grain cart and tractor before we do anything more. There. Yeah, I was hoping to have us up to where we were chopping only, but not quite there as you can see. Right, we got our settings all set up, so let's head on up here and repair this guy. Yeah, the combine was down to under 100 liters of fuel, so we had to fuel them up. There we go. That's all fixed up. I'll put this guy in the field and get him waiting on the combine. He's going to drive the course, which is alright. We got our auger. So we have a few bins full already. We're on our fourth bin, I think. Yeah. Yep, fourth bin. Open up our bin here. Oops, the next one. And this bin's just about full. So we'll have 4 full bins, and then we'll fill up a partial of a fifth. So our truck is full and ready to rock. So as you can see, here's our chopper, the John Deere 8600i, and then also a Kenworth T600, and the unlimited modding silage trailer. I did a little bit of silage just to test and see if course play was going to work for me, and it did not. And then here we have a Case International 9190, and I got to figure out how the heck you add the duals on this thing. I know it has duals. I know they're not IC controlled. I got damage over there. What's the wrong button? Well, I've seen pictures of people using duals on it. I'll have to look. But this is what we're going to use for compacting. And, oops. I'll tab backwards here. And we'll shut the door on this guy. I'll show you guys, we got a fair amount of silage already just in this bunker, just from one. This is one truckload, and it's already 13% full. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to head on in to the yard with this truckload of grain. We'll come on back, and then we'll see what happens with Follow Me Mod. Not sure how well it's going to want to work. That truck, it likes to hit the brakes quite often. And it ruins the trailer. So, I don't know, we'll see what happens with it. Our Peterbilt's getting pretty dirty now. Stop the truck here. So we have to go to these guys where they're being completely stupid again, causing us to have to drive over the crop and ruin the crop quite a bit. Ah, the joys of horseplay. Gotta love it. As nice as it is, it's also a giant pain. We'll just empty it out here, I guess, and then, yeah, that's what I thought you would do. Alright, get this guy to drive again. So we got a bunch of straw there, which is the worst part of course play. Growing up, because then we have to drive over the crop when it's this direction. And that's always fun. What is your field space like? 15, 10. Okay, you're not in traffic, you stupid thing. Oh, the joys of course play. Alright, here we go. Let's get this thing to the field. To the farm, sorry. So, yeah, I've been doing some more work on my map lately. I'm working on... Or just this morning here, I was working on power lines. Getting those added in at along the highway. And then I'll go back and add the ones along the... Along the gravel roads and stuff, and then I made up a just kind of a quick little transform box for at houses and stuff. Not the best thing ever, but I'm just doing up something little quick. It's just gonna be sitting in different areas by houses and stuff, anyways, so not too worried about it. For some reason today I'm getting terrible frame rate. I don't know why. And then I got all the prices adjusted for the fields and all of the sizes adjusted as well in the user attributes for the fields. I'll go right around with the combine for a little bit. See, I'll show you guys here. We'll fire this guy up. this guy fired up. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the Jake brake on in this. So maybe we'll have to drive the thing ahead a little bit. Toss out some silage, I guess, but whatever. There we go. So as you can see, our trailer just took 19% damage. So we'll have to keep a consistent speed. Even that is going to completely total it. Suck. I tried getting this thing to go on course play, but it wouldn't. Let's see, we're in field 2 here. No, we're not. We're in field 3. What am I thinking? Let's just see if it's going to work. Oh, now it's going to decide. Now it'll decide that it wants to work. There we go, now we can ride alongside of him and chop this stuff. I don't know why he wasn't working before. I must have just been starting it in a weird spot or something, and that's what was causing it. But it's working now. The silage isn't the best yielding, I guess, but it's getting the job done. We'll have enough silage to last us for a while, so we'll be fine. If we can fill one bunker between these two fields, I'll be happy. I don't know how much these bunkers hold, but I'm sure they hold quite a bit. So yeah, for my map, it's got a total of 1,932 acres on it, roughly. I did do some rounding down and rounding up when I was figuring out the field sizes, so, you know, it's not 100%. The largest field is 150 acres, which is $26,250 to buy, and the smallest is 5 acres, which only costs $875 to buy. Each field is $175 an acre, and that is a realistic price. I looked it up for land prices for this area, for non-irrigated crop land, and it was $175 an acre. So that's I just took, you know, once I converted the hectares to acres, I just took that and multiplied it by the size and multiplied it by 175, and that gave me the price. So I know I showed that in the end of my latest video for my map, but not everybody watches it. I've gotten a lot of comments on last week's video where I said let me know what other games you would like to see. And I've gotten a lot of construction sims, some BMG, some spin tires, all sorts of things. So I will work on incorporating that into the schedule eventually. I'm not sure when, but we'll get there eventually. I don't think there's anything else. Just need to get whipped around here. So evidently this trailer does not like when you use the brakes, which is kind of annoying, but let's get the combine unloading. So one bad thing about that, combine, but once we can afford to, we'll be getting a different one, so we'll be fine. I did figure out, if you guys remember from the last video, I wasn't sure which header for the John Deere combine had the wheels. It is this first one, not the second one, it's this first one here. They're both 640Ds, but one of them has wheels and one of them doesn't. That's about the only difference in them. So yeah, I've been working on my map as much as I can. I'm going to have to call my papa here later today and ask him a few questions on some stuff. I didn't take pictures, stupidly, I didn't take pictures of the bin to figure out like its size, like its height and its width and all that stuff. So I'll have to call my papa and, you know, just see, because I got to figure out how many bushels the bins can hold and how many bushels the elevator can hold. And then just for the Tenvik area, I'm not worried about the farm quite yet. I'll be working on that later on. I'm just working on one area at a time. So yeah, once I finish putting in the power lines along the highway, I'm gonna go through and add in the surrounding area farms, and then I'll go through and add the power lines along the roads, and then after that it'll be adding trees and rocks and molehills and other details and stuff like that, and then, you know, be working on whatever else needs to be done or whatever else I can do at that time. Yeah, we need to get our truck back. Our auger moved on us again, but, well, whatever. So be it. So our bin is 94% full, so one more truckload and it'll be filled up to the top. And then we'll start on another bin and we'll probably fill that a pretty fair amount. And if we fill that and still have more wheat to harvest, we'll just haul it to the elevator and sell it straight off rather than, you know, use another bin up. And then it'll also be, you know, we'll also try and get out of the red a little bit if we can, just so we have some little, a little bit more money to work with. Yeah, I'm going to be... you know, I said this before, doing some edits to this map again. I need to take the clip off of the trees up there by that farm, and then I'm going to... Jeez, what was the other thing? I was going to check and see if that feed building had the triggers and piles in it for when we put our bins or our bales away. And then we can put our bales in there. but I haven't done that yet. And then I'm also going to try and get the viable triggers working. So that way we can take our hopper trailer and drive up to like CPS and fill it with fertilizer or seed. Well, we'll probably end up just doing fertilizer, I think. But I'll have to do some testing with it. But then we can buy fertilizer, and then we can use the Brandt auger and auger fertilizer from the trailer to the spreader. I saw Jake Evan doing that on a map that he's playing on, and asked him how he got it so he could fill the trailer, and he told me how, and so I'll have to figure it out, because it's a lot more realistic of a way rather than using the liquid trailer for solid fertilizer as well. So we still have quite a bit of wheat to harvest, but we're getting closer and closer. We're on the last field, so if only the grain cart could keep up with the combine, then we'd be able to keep cutting and we could cut faster, but oh well, we'll get her done. We got plenty of other stuff to keep us busy in the meantime, so we got this the straw to chop and grain to truck, so we'll hop a cab here and open up our window. It sucks that the mirror doesn't actually like show anything. I had an adjustable mirror mod, but it never really worked, and I couldn't figure out how to get it to work. So, or that's what I mean by it wouldn't work. So, all right, we're full, so let's head on out of here. Now we're gonna pull up by the truck, by the pickup here, and repair our truck and trailer. Now we'll do some in-cab trucking. Turn the Jake on. Hop in the pickup and hit R. Now our stuff is completely repaired. Oh, and our combine unloaded itself. See, there's been times where like the combine will unload itself, and then other times where it won't. So it's like, come on, make up your mind, combine, if you're gonna unload yourself or not. So I hope everybody had a good weekend. I sure did. I spent my Saturday working on my bike project. I've got a mountain bike that I tore it apart as far as I possibly could. And then I'm now working on stripping all the paint and decals off of it. And then I'm going to paint it. I'm going to paint it new colors. I won't have any decals on it anymore and stuff, but that doesn't matter to me. So, I'm going to drive through this bunker and back on into the other one. Okay, so there is a little fill plane there in the center, I guess. Oops, I'm moving forward, not backwards. Alright, so yeah, I'm going to wait to compact it until it's either full or we're done, which I'm going to assume is going to be full, comes first. And, you know, hopefully we fill both bunkers and have extra. You know, I mean, it'd be nice to have an overabundance of silage in a way, because then we wouldn't have to do silage for quite a while. But, you know, whatever happens, happens, I guess. And if we do end up filling both bunkers and end up needing, having more silage, then we will just use the, alternative tipping mod. To dump it out in a big pile someplace, whether it's in a building or just out under the stars. Is our combine going to automatically unload? Yes, it is. I just don't get it. Here we go for another load. So yeah, back to when I was talking about the weekend. Yeah, so like I said, I've been working on my bike. I've spent probably $100 on it already, sadly. But I got the bike for free, so I guess really you can't complain. I spent just about $35 on new parts for it. My rear brake system completely gave up on me. So I had to buy new rear brake couplers, which are the parts that squeeze together. I had to buy new rear brake couplers and 4 new brake pads, because before that I only had 2 brake pads and they were on the back. And now you hit the brakes and you leave a skid mark, and you hit the front brakes and you just about go flying off. So mission accomplished there. And then I've spent probably, well, I've spent over $100. I spent $80 on tools and paint. I bought tools to work on stripping the paint, and then I bought paint for it. I'm gonna paint it. It was black and white, but I'm gonna paint the entire thing black, and then go back with like maybe some blue or some green, and do some like stripes or something on it. Just give it kind of a neat design. One day when I was at Ace Hardware, I was looking at paint, and they had Alice Chalmers Orange, John Deere Green, and John Deere Yellow, and I kind of thought, it'd be kind of funny to just paint the entire thing Alice Chalmers Orange and then go back with, like, John Deere Green and John Deere Yellow stripes. That'd be so funny. It'd definitely have quite the look. No doubt about that. Okay, I don't want my lights on anymore. But, yeah, I just thought it'd be kind of funny to do that, but not going to. Because as funny as it would look, it'd also look quite strange. But then on Sunday, we went to the lake to hang out at my grandpa's camper. And he has a big, huge boat. And it's not a fishing boat. It's just kind of like a, chillaxing boat. And we went and drove around in that. And that was fun. So we spent the day up there and had a lot of fun. Wow, already over. Well guys, I guess that's gonna do it for me for this video. If you enjoyed the video, hit the thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. And if you haven't already, make sure you turn on my post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time and Saturdays at noon, which will be changing once we incorporate new games to the channel. Make sure you check out down below in the description for links to all my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Off camera, I will finish up chopping this field and hopefully finish up combining that field over there. And when we come back, we'll be chopping that field, hopefully. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next.